Greatness comes from knowing that no matter how good you are as an individual, your best and most powerful work is to be a servant to something greater than yourself. As a new alum, I am thinking about my path to the University of Miami and all that I learned here as a student. You see, I'm from Overtown, and I'm proud to say that. A community many of you know faces many challenges. There aren't enough jobs for people to support their families. We've become numb to the sounds of guns in our streets. Rents are rising, pushing decent, affordable housing out of reach, and our local business owners struggle to grow a local economy. Growing up, I lost people to guns, I lost people to violence, I lost people to prison, and I lost my father to cancer. Though these stories aren't just in Overtown. There are many communities around the world that you hear about. But there's another story you may not know, the story of strength in neighborhoods like mine. I grew up in a village of support, strong support. You can see my mother, my two brothers, and my niece. See, my mother, she did not allow for any excuses. My sister, she did not let me lose focus. And my family did not let me settle for the University of Texas or Arkansas. My godfather, my great aunt, and my uncles, they all helped raise me. What I got in Overtown was the strongest foundation I could get. I learned respect, I learned honesty, and I learned the power of believing. I was taught to look ahead and to believe that change in my life was possible despite everything around me in my community. Though this is not what you think of when you hear about Overtown or Opa-locka, Liberty City, Wynwood. You don't hear these things. You don't even think about these things. But I'm living proof, standing before you, that these communities have strength, have love, and build real leadership. So I want to make it really clear, that I was lucky to be raised in Overtown, a community of caring that gave me incredible gifts which guided me every single day. And one of these gifts was sports. Yes, in high school, I played football and basketball. But believe it or not, I'm not your average football player. I played 1 year of football. 1 year, it wasn't until my senior year that I stepped on a football field. And after just one practice, I had three offers from three major universities. My high school coach told me, son, put that basketball down. It's time to play some football because that's going to get me the education that I need. And my family had always told me that your first priority is to get that degree. So I chose football because it would get me that degree. And I chose the University of Miami because there's no better place to play football or to get an education. Growing up in Miami, playing for the Hurricanes was a dream come true. My time at UM changed my life, and I want to share with you four lessons that I am taking with me. First, I learned the power of team. When you're a freshman, you think it's all about you. You're a star in high school, you're an All-American, you have the recruiters telling you how great you are, but in the instant, you're recruited by UM, you become a star, a hero at home. But when I got here, it was really lonely. At home, I had my community, I had my family. But when I got here, what did I have? But I had one friend, Chad Thomas, my best friend from high school, who plays for the Cleveland Browns right now. He came with me to Miami to play football, and he helped me see what this university could be. We made a tight pack of friends who showed me unity. There are 10 of us who still talk and text almost every single day. That team got me through the challenging moments. We also began to see that with a degree from the University of Miami, it could set you up for life. So I decided to study political science. I learned that for our political system to work together, it needs teamwork too. Elected officials have more power when they collaborate, and communities can make real change when they work together and come together. At UM, I saw the power of teamwork, both on and off the field. The second thing I learned here was the power of voice. On the field, you have to be able to listen. You have to be able to exchange information. There's so many games I can remember. I couldn't see nothing what Coach Golden was saying, Coach Diaz, or Coach Rick was saying. It's just, you have to know. It's just certain things you know. You have to look at hand signals. You just have to know certain things. But at UMI, also learn that you have to speak up if you need help. You have to let someone know if you're struggling. And you have to be a voice for others when they need it. That's what's lacking in our society today. My nickname in the locker room was the preacher. You probably can tell. You know, I got that name because I took my job seriously. I used my voice to help players coming behind me and players in front of me, like Duke Johnson, Eric Flowers, Aquadine Muhammad. Stay focused on what was really important. To this day, I remember the Wisconsin game in New York, the Pinstripe Bowl. Man, that was a tough defeat. Cold, uniforms muddy. And I get in the locker room, and I ask Coach Rick. I say, Coach Rick, let me say something to the guys. Because I'm a senior. This is it. 5-year career, I'm wrapping it up. It's time to go. And I tell the guys, do not let this one game determine the outcome of your career. You go off the field and make bad decisions. And after that, I called everybody on me. And we broke it down, 1, 2, 3 family. Everyone went their separate ways. And Coach Rick ended it right there. I wasn't thinking, but when I think back on it, that was odd. He ended it right there and said to the team that I had a voice of reason and purpose. And a month later, Coach Rick retired. I'm like, whoa, retired? We got something to do. We ain't finished, even though I'm not a part of it, but we got something to finish. And to think, he gave me his last locker room talk. His last locker room talk, think about it. His last locker room talk. And at UM, I learned that strong leaders know how to listen and that using your voice can be a powerful way to make change. The third thing I learned as a Cane was to work really hard. Really hard for what you want. Look, effort is between you and you. That's a quote by Ray Lewis in our locker room. I look at it every single day. Every single day when I go to practice. Lacing up my cleats, putting my gloves on, putting the tape around my wrist, because when I step on that field, I'm a different man. I'm not the man you're talking to right now. It's game time on Green Tree. I'm getting chills just talking about it. You know what I'm saying? I had to work hard to get to UM. And when I got here, nothing was ever handed to me. From the time I stepped foot on campus in May 2014 to my last game as a Hurricane last December, I learned that from day one, I had to do the work, first of all. That's the most important thing. I had to stand up for myself. I had to go out on the field and work hard every single day. I had to earn my starting position. I had to earn my grades. And 3 years ago, I had to earn my spot in Iron Arrow Society. And make no mistake, balancing football and academics is not easy. It's never going to get easy. Last spring, I walked across the stage with a degree in political science and a master's in public administration. I'm extremely proud to hold 2 degrees from this major university. I learned that there's no replacement for hard work, sweat, or tears. I learned that when you get knocked down, you have to get up. You see, in football, I faced many injuries, but I had no choice. I'm from Overtown. I'm a Cane, and I learned what it meant to keep fighting. I earned a starting position my junior season. In just 214 snaps, to sum it up, probably about 8 games, so you know, sum it up for you. I missed just one tackle. Just one tackle. And then the game against Virginia Tech, everything, you know, started to change. You know, that was God talking to me, telling you, hey, it's time for a new path. I tore my knee. You know, I had a great guy do my surgery. Great guy. Seriously. I came back the fall for my senior season and realized, hey, you know, my knee wasn't feeling the same. I rehabbed. I had a perfect surgery. I did everything that they asked me to do. I ate right. I slimmed down. So I said, you know what, hey, that's just doubt. I'm going to keep pushing ahead. So I said, you know, would it feel better this game? No. So I worked even harder. I come 6, won't leave till 10 at night. Class, study hall, come back 10 at night. We got to work. We got to put work in. So I said, would it be better this game? No. What about this game? No. I realized that my knee would never be the same. And with that, I lost the love for the game. I lost the love to play it. I didn't even want to get touched. Don't hit me. I don't even want to play no more. So I made the most difficult choice. I had to walk away from the game that I love. Mind you, my mind clocked out the fifth game of the season. Because I said, it's over with. I'm not the same Demetrius Jackson that I used to be. But that was God telling me, it's time to go to a different path. But do I push ahead to the NFL? That had been the plan all along. That was the playoff. That was the payoff, working hard from my senior year all the way 6-7 years into this thing. I invested so much. I planted my seeds. Come on, now I'm ready to reap. I'm ready to reap the harvest. I'm ready to get the benefits, the fruits of my labor. But hey, no. The knee injury was not part of this plan. I knew I could keep going and playing with this injury because I'm a tough guy, you know. But I decided to change course. I decided to walk away from the game that I love. I decided to do that. And the role I had been training for so long, it was terrifying. It was depressing. I didn't even want to go to practice. I didn't want to go to class. This was a huge loss. And I don't know if you noticed, but Canes, we don't like to lose. But then I remember what brought me to the University of Miami. My mind went back to that spring of my senior season. I remember to believe in a different future. I remember what my family had told me, that my first priority was to get a degree. Choose the University of Miami, they said, and that degree will open doors. And standing before you, you can see that it has opened doors. As a defensive end, you got to work hard. You got to be flexible. You got to be quick, and you got to be strong. You got to be able to change course, and I'm happy. I did. And the decision to walk away from the NFL led me to my fourth and most important lesson. The power to give back. This picture right here was taken 2 days after I had my knee surgery. You can imagine the pain I'm in. 2 days. My time at UM showed me the power to give back. When you're a Miami Hurricane, you got people's attention. And I tried to use that attention to give back to communities like mine, like Overtown, Liberty City, Alapata, who gave me so much. We did turkey drives and brought Thanksgiving meals to hundreds. Hundreds. We spoke at schools trying to spread the message to the young people that education should win over violence. We collected supplies for kids at schools. And the thing that I'm most proud of, we started a college fund for kids at my high school. I saw what happened when I asked other people to get involved. I saw what happened when I asked Mr. Blake James to get involved. I saw what happened when I asked half of you in this room to get involved. $10 go a long way when providing a Thanksgiving meal to a family. The coaches got involved, the fans got involved, the students got involved. We all pitched in, we donated, and we showed out. UM gave me a platform I used to bring people together, to do things right. You have with that platform, you can either be good or you can be great. You choose, ain't no tipping the scale. I am taking these lessons with me to make my neighborhood better for the next generation and the next generation after that. You see, I came from a strong village of support, and I want to help that grow. I am teaching in the heart of Liberty City, and I'm an assistant football coach at my former high school, Booker T. Washington Senior High. Not the largest, but the best, baby. And guess what? Guess what? I decided to run and represent my district, Overtown, Liberty City, in District 109, the Florida House of Representatives, come next August. Thank you. So check this out. I know that my most powerful work is to be a servant to something greater. And trust me, my work isn't done yet. Thank you.